Hi. In this example, we're going to take a look at how to simplify an expression like this that has a mixture of both rational and integer exponents. The rational exponents are the fractions. This means that there's going to be a lot of addition and subtraction with fractions. For the most part, I'm going to go ahead and just do that, but for the last example, when we get to the very end of it, I'll actually do it out showing the common denominator in each of the steps along the way. The rest of the time, as I said, I'm going to simplify things just for the time factor to keep the video a little bit shorter. So, first off, the rules for how to handle this are exactly the same as handling a problem when all of the exponents are integers. We just now have to do multiplication, addition, and subtraction with fractions. So first off, with our order of operations, is to deal with the parentheses. The first set of parentheses we have here gives us x to the 1/3 times y. Now there's nothing to do here. This quantity is not being raised to an exponent. There's no number in front. There's no plus sign there, so there's no kind of distribution. Really, these parentheses are entirely unnecessary. They're just showing multiplication. So I'm going to go ahead and rewrite this amount without the parentheses. So I have x to the 1/3 times y. Now my next set of parentheses, and here you'll notice we do in fact have this exponent to the 4th power, which means we're going to have to take everything inside here and raise each individual part to the 4th power. First off, 3 to the 4th power. Now instead of multiplying that out and getting 81, I'm just going to write it as 3 to the 4th power, because we're looking to ultimately simplify this, and keeping everything in this exponent notation is going to help us out a lot. Next up, I have x to the 1/2 raised to the 4th power. Now remember, the power rule for exponents tells us that when we have an exponent raised to another exponent, we're going to go ahead and multiply those two exponents together, which means my next part in my answer here is going to be x raised to the 1/2 times 4, which is 4/2. We'll go ahead and simplify that fraction in just a minute, but for right now I'll leave it as 4/2. Next up, I have the y's. Y to the negative 1/3 raised to the 4th power, I need to go ahead and again multiply those two exponents together. So I'm going to end up with y to the negative 4/3, which is what I get when I multiply negative 1/3 and 4 together. All of this will be over my 9, which is 3 squared. Again, to help simplify, I'm going to rewrite that in its exponent notation, because again, it does help me go ahead and simplify ultimately. This 3 squared is times x to the 3rd, y to the negative 1/2. There were no parentheses to deal with down there, so there was no simplifying yet done. This is what I have now. So I'm going to move this up to have some more room and to get rid of the original problem so it's not causing any confusion. Next up, and there are a lot of different ways you can tackle this problem. You don't have to do it the exact same way that I'm doing it. This is just the technique that I find the easiest to sort of avoid as much confusion as possible. What I want to do next is deal with the negative exponents, because in our final simplified answer, we do not want any negative exponents anywhere. So you'll notice here in the bottom, I've got this y to the negative 1/2, and here in the top, this y to the negative 4/3. I want to convert both of these so that I get rid of the negative exponent. The way negative exponents work is that you take the reciprocal. So in just the simplest terms, if it's in the top part of the fraction, we're going to actually go ahead and move it down to the bottom part. So from the numerator down into the denominator. When we do that, we'll make the exponent positive. If it was in the bottom to begin with, we're going to go ahead and move it up into the top, meaning moving it from the denominator up into the numerator. Again, when we move it, we make the exponent positive. So I'm going to go ahead and rewrite this with those two quantities in their correct location so that they have positive exponents. That's going to give me, well, still x to the 1/3, that hasn't changed, times y, times 3 to the 4th, times x to the 4/2, and like we said, we can go ahead and simplify that. 4/2, 4 divided by 2 is x squared. Now, instead of this y to the negative 4/3, I'm going to have y to the positive 1/2. We're going to take this amount, move it into the numerator, and when we do that, make the exponent positive, which gives me y to the 1/2 up here in the top. All of that is over 3 squared times x cubed times, now this amount that used to be in the numerator, y to the negative 4/3, when we move it down into the denominator, we make the exponent positive, which gives me y to the positive 4/3 down here. You notice this, now all of the exponents are nice and positive, which means we can start combining things together to start having these variables and numbers show up less often. So again, let me move this up. So we just have our most current version here on the screen. This is what we're working with right now. So what we end up with, to make things as easy as possible, we're going to try to combine stuff together, which means I'm going to go ahead and rearrange it so similar things are together. First off, I'm going to put the coefficients, so the numbers, 3 to the 4th. Next, I'm going to put all the x's together. So for my original problem, I have x to the 3rd and x squared. Next up, I have y and y to the 1/2. All of that's being multiplied. So all I did was rearrange it to have it be in a more convenient order. In the bottom, I'm going to match the same order, meaning I will have 3 squared times x cubed times y to the 4/3. Now we're going to go ahead and combine any parts that have the same base, doing the top first and then the bottom. You notice here in the bottom, each base shows up once. I have 3, here I have an x, here I have a y, so there's nothing to combine. But in the top, I have these x's showing up twice, x to the 1/3 and x squared. Here I have y. Y, by the way, is y to the 1st power, so if that helps, I'm going to go ahead and put that exponent in for us to see. So I have y to the 1st power times y to the 1/2. Well, the product rule for exponents tells us that when we have them like this, we can combine them together so long as the base matches by adding the exponents together. So I'm going to go ahead and combine these two by adding the exponents together, and I'm going to go ahead and add these two, or combine these two, by adding the exponents together. So I will have, once I move this up again, in a slightly shorter form, 3 to the 4th times x. And this is where I said I was going to go ahead and add these fractions together. You're going to need to find a common denominator and then add the fractions. But when we do that, we're going to end up with x to the 7/3. Now the y's. Again, find a common denominator for both of these and add them together, and we'll end up with y to the 3/2. That's it simplified. So at least x and y are both showing up just once in the top. This is over 3 squared times x to the cubed, or x to the 3rd rather, sorry, times y to the 4/3. Now to continue simplifying, we do have each base showing up just once in the top, once in the bottom, but now we just want it to show up once overall in the entire problem. So we're going to go ahead and look at these as sort of three separate parts. You notice we have these 3s, these x's, and these y's. The quotient rule for exponents tells us that we can simplify these if the base matches. So as we have here, 3 and 3, those bases match. We can combine them together in 1 by subtracting the exponents. So let me move this up yet again. And what we're going to have here is 3, this first base, to the upper exponent 4 minus the lower 1, 2. So the quotient rule again says that we can combine them together if the base matches, so they're both 3 as the base, by subtracting the exponents, the top one minus the bottom. For the x's, since they match, x in the top, x in the bottom, the base matches, we're going to end up subtracting those exponents. So 7/3 minus 3. Now for the y's, y to the 3/2, the top exponent minus the bottom one, 4/3. Since we have one base showing up, or each base showing up one time, once we simplify these exponents, just do the addition, or in this instance, all the subtraction, we will have this in a more simplified form. Again, simplified meaning things showing up less often. So here, what we've got, well, we just need to go ahead and do the subtraction. So 3 to the 4 minus 2, that's the easiest of all of them we have here. That's just going to be 3 squared. Now for the x's and y's, and this is where I said I'll actually find the common denominator and show it to you. Remember, for this problem, 7/3 minus 3, 3 is really 3 over 1. Looking at it as a fraction may help. So 3 is going to be my common denominator for both. So I'll have 7/3, which stays exactly the same. For the second one, I'm going to multiply top and bottom by 3 so that I have my common denominator, which is going to give me 9/3. Those are the two amounts that I need to subtract. For y, here we have 3/2 minus 4/3. My common denominator is going to be a 6. So for the first one, I'm going to multiply top and bottom by 3, giving me 9/6. For the second one, top and bottom of this fraction by 2, giving me 8/6, both of which have the common denominator in it. Now I'm ready to just go ahead and subtract. So, again, 3 squared, all done and ready. For this one, when I subtract the exponents, 7/3 minus 9/3, I end up with a negative amount. It happens, there's nothing wrong with that. We have negative 2/3. For the other one, when I subtract 9/6 minus 8/6, we end up with y to the 1/6. And we're almost done. It is correct, we have each base once, which we want. But you notice in doing the subtraction, I ended up with another negative exponent. In our final answer, we want no negative exponents whatsoever. So I need to take this amount right here, and as we did before, take the reciprocal. Meaning since it's in the top of my expression, I'm going to move it down into the denominator. Even though there isn't a denominator present now, I'm just going to go ahead and move it down. So when I write it out, remember when you move it, you want to take it from being negative to being positive. I'm going to end up with 3 squared, which is 9, times y to the 1/6 over x to the 2/3. And that's my final answer. To be in the full simplified form, what we want to have is each base showing up just once, and having no negative exponents whatsoever. So that large expression that we began with in the beginning of this problem simplifies down to this, 9 times y to the 1/6 over x to the 2/3.